What's going on, guys? Nico, Disability Service. Nico, Life Coach, and I am Warren Prudup, and today is Sunday. I don't know if you can see me in this camera or not, but I'm going to be moving around a little bit anyhow, because today we are going to release stress, and the way to release some stress is to get up and move around. The first thing I'm going to do is get on this scale and see how much weight stress do I have. Because I know I have been stressing out. Have y'all been stressing out lately? Talk about it to me. Let's see what this scale is going to say. How fat are you today? I'm probably about 10 pounds overweight. Let's see. pounds. That's out. That's crazy. But it's stress. So let me put this blood cuffing on. I don't know if y'all can see me here, but I got this blood pressure monitor. My blood pressure normally is about 118 over about 80. I got a feeling it's a little higher today. We're going to check it. Let's see if I get this thing to work. Alright. So, what kind of stress y'all have in your life today? Put something in that comment, because I know that we all have it.
The average of the previous three measurements.
No, we don't want to do this. We don't want to do this. We want to start this measurement. Come on. Let's go. All right. Why is not working? So put something in that comment. We all have stress. It's okay. It's what we're going to do about it. It's what we got to figure out. So let me see what my blood pressure is. If just talking blood pressure will work for me, maybe just need to do something different. Alright, it doesn't want to work for me today. So we're going to give up. We're going to try one more time. Let's see. No. Alright, come on, guys. Come on, comments. I see about one or two of them in there. What are you stressing about? We all have it. But what we're going to do about it is the big question. Is what can we do about it? Well, I'm going to shave. I'm going to clean myself up a little bit. So that helps release some stress. Here's my blood pressure now. It's telling me to stand still, don't talk. So seem correct. So let's see if we can get this one more time on the other arm. Get a better reading. Come on. So, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Been a long week. Many things happen. But what do you do about those stressful things? Give me some ideas. Can we go for a run? Can we...
Stay still. All right. Do not talk until the measurement is complete.
We're going to try one more time. I had the cuff on wrong.
The average of the previous 3 months.
Let's try it one more time. I had the cuff on wrong. So, see, it's important to take your blood pressure and keep up with it, because you go to the doctor every 3 months and you take your blood pressure. Most people stress before they go into the doctor's office anyhow, so your blood pressure is normally off. So it's never normally accurate. And doctors live on that. They like to put you on blood pressure medication because you took one or two tests. You walked to the doctor's office, you got on the bus, you drove through traffic. You don't want to be there. Your stress levels.
All right,
come on. We don't want to do this. We want to take our blood pressure. So, you go to the doctor and they take a blood pressure. And you go back 3 months later and they take it again. And they take it an average. And they say your blood pressure is too high. Have you ever done that before? Then they put you on this medication because you're stressed out. What are you really stressing about? But the bigger question is, how can you get rid of it? See, this machine don't want to act right because I did it a couple too many times. But we're going to try it one more time. If it doesn't work this time, we're going to give up. Alright, it doesn't want to work. So, I did do it earlier today with 144 over 84, which is a little high for me because it's normally at 118. But I got a lot of stress on me today. 1 year ago was the last day I saw my mother live and talking. When I walked out of her room, I kind of had in the back of my mind I probably wouldn't see her again, because I knew they was moving her to a different hospital, and she did pass on the 24th of August of 2019, and just recently, a couple weeks ago, my grandmother passed on July the 30th. She was my heart. So today is not a good day. But today I know God is still in control. So what I'm going to do, because I know I have to get rid of some of this stress, I am going to exercise a little bit. Let me make sure this is looking at y'all pretty good. I'm going to get on this Total Gym right here behind me. I'm going to use some weights. I'm going to take a good shower afterwards. Shave, put on me a good meal, which has some beans soaking right now, mix some lentil beans. I stopped eating meat a year ago, in December, almost a year, and I'm feeling good. I stopped smoking cigarettes a year and a half ago. See, I'm getting myself healthy, even though I've been stressing, it's important to stay healthy. Every day. I stopped smoking cigarettes, no problem. I stopped eating meat without any problems, so I could lose a good 10 pounds But I want you to come back every week, every Sunday, around noontime. Let's get on that scale. Let's get that blood pressure and temperature checked because it's coronavirus. Make sure that we don't have that. Make sure that we are staying healthy. Lose that stress. You know, some of us may be grieving. Yes, and it's hard, but it doesn't last forever. Some of us may be just going through financial difficulties right now, and that doesn't last forever either. Just have to trust God. Some of us is dealing with families, members, co-workers, church families, and they may be stressing you out a little bit too. Well, it's Sunday afternoon. If you didn't have a chance to worship today, put on some good old gospel music, put on a good old pot of food, release that stress, you know, that stress will kill you. And baby, I'm not trying to go nowhere right now, but I want you to go to my website, Nickel, I-N-I-K-O, Life Coaching. Hit that registration button, 30-minute consultation with me, and I can tell you how I got out of that wheelchair. I can tell you I made it to a long-term stay in a rehab. I can tell you how I went in and out of two nursing homes, and I made it. I can tell you how I went through 18 operations in 9 months. A lot of stress. I can tell you how I fell down and I got back up. I can tell you how I fell down and I kept getting back up. You know, grandmother used to always say, sometimes you have to go to the altar and just fall down. And when you get back up, you'll be better than when you fell down. I believe that. So if you fell down this week, stay down there for a while, pray about it, and then get back up. I love you guys. Warren Crill. Turn this off.